here that growth hormones, GH is growth hormones. The another name of the growth hormone is somatotropin. So it causes to the, it stimulates the cytolysis and cells of the cartilage bones and striated muscle. Okay, so the growth hormone stimulates the secretions of liver that produce insulin like growth factor, ILGF, insulin like growth factors. So the growth hormone stimulates the all tissues and that causes to the protein synthesis. Okay, so that accelerating the protein synthesis and here decreasing the catabolism of proteins. Okay, catabolism of proteins. So see here, the growth hormone releasing hormone is stomatocrinin, and the growth hormone inhibits the hormone is stomatostatin. Okay, so let's see again that GH is growth hormone, so that also called as somatotropin. It accelerates and it functioned as the cytolysis and cell growth and cells of the cartilage bone and striated muscles. It accelerates these type of activities and the growth hormone stimulates the secretions of the liver that produces the insulin like growth factors. Okay, right, the growth hormone and responds and that accelerate and that secretes the all tissues and that controlled by the all tissues, so that causes to the producing of protein synthesis. So here another one is accelerating of the protein synthesis and the growth hormone stimulates the controlation of or decreasing of the catabolism of proteins. So here the growth hormone releasing hormone is somatocrinin and the growth hormone inhibit the hormone is stomatostatin. Okay, so next prolactin. Okay, right, second one is prolactin. So it is also called luteotrophic hormone. So generally in females, these hormone will helps to enlargement of the mammary glands. So in the duration of pregnancy, that prolactin will helps to eject the or production of that mammary glands of the breast to produce the milk. Okay, see once here the prolactin is the luteotrophic hormone. Okay, so in females, this hormone will helps to enlargement of the mammary glands. So that will helps to ejection or production of that milk after the birth. Okay, after the birth, right here. So the prolactin, there is no function of the prolactin in males. We could not find that what is the function of that prolactin in males. So what is the function of prolactin in males. Okay, next, see here, that prolactin is the another activity is development of the corpus luteum in females. Okay, right, so the next hormone is thyroid stimulating hormone. Thyroid stimulating hormone. TSH. So TSH means here thyroid stimulating hormone. Thyroid stimulating hormone. So the synthesis and the secretions of the thyroid synthesis and secretions, synthesis and stimulation of the secretions of thyroid hormones from the thyroid gland. Okay, thyroid gland. Okay, so next ACTH. ACTH. Fourth one is ACTH. So the ACTH is that full form of ACTH is adrenocorticotrophic hormone. Adrenocorticotrophic hormone. Trophic hormone. See here the ACTH, that means stimulation and the synthesis and the stimulation of that secretion of the steroid hormones, from the adrenal cortex, So the synthesis and stimulation of the secretion of steroid hormones from the adrenal cortex is the function of the ACTH. So next one is F, follicle stimulating hormone, FSH. Fifth one is follicle stimulating hormone. So FSH means here follicle stimulating hormone. Follicle stimulating hormone. Right. In females, the FSH stimulates the ovarian follicles. In the ovary. Okay. So as well as in males, the FSH. Follicle stimulation, stimulating hormone. So that combines along with androgens. So that connects with the testosterone. So that regulates the spermatogenesis. See here once. FSH, that is the follicle stimulating hormone, right? So what is the function of the FSH in females? So it stimulates the ovarian follicles in the ovary. So that is the helpful in corpus luteum, that is in the menstrual cycle. So whenever the menstrual cycle is started, so here that ovarian follicle is development in the ovary is the function of FSH. And next, as well as in the function of FSH in males, so that is combines along with the androgens. FSH combines along with the androgens, that means here testosterone. So here these combination will regulates the spermatogenesis. So the production of the spermatozoa is called as spermatogenesis. So here the regulation means going forward in the order way. So such a order indicates the regulation of the spermatogenesis. So that is the continuation process. Okay, next, luteinizing hormone, LH. Sixth one is luteinizing hormone. So generally in LH means luteinizing hormones. Right. So these luteinizing hormone in males, so it is the stimulation of the leading cells of testes that secretes the sperms. Okay, right. So these in males, the luteinizing hormones, it is stimulates the leading cells of the testes that produce the sperms in testes. Okay, right. In female, that luteinizing hormone will helps to development of the corpus luteum, growth and development of the corpus luteum. Okay, let's see here that already I told that one of the place or that is one pars intermedia. So these pars intermedia that releases one of the peptide hormone that is MSH, melanocyte stimulating hormone. So it regulates the pigmentation of body skin. It like regulates the body pigmentation of the skin. Okay, so melanocyte stimulating hormone. Okay, let's see that hormones of the posterior pituitary gland. Okay, so that means hormones of the neurohypophysis. So here over that anterior pituitary hormones and pars intermedia of the hormones. So let's see that hormones of the neurohypophysis. So here these hormones are derived from the neurohypophysis. These hormones are two types. So first one is oxytocin, and next is vasopressin. So these are the peptide hormones, and these are framed by the small peptide chains. Okay, so the neurohypophysis hormones are two types. In that, first one is oxytocin, second one is vasopressin. These hormones are small hormones or small peptide protein hormones. Okay, or peptide chains, small peptide chains, or these are peptide hormones. Let's see that oxytocin. So here the oxytocin induces the contractions. So it induces the contractions. So while we are going to take that oxytocin in females during the pregnancy or during the delivery time, so the extraction or contractions of the uterine muscles. So when it is enlarged of the uterine muscles, so then automatically the baby will come out. So here the enlargement and the contractions of the uterine muscles, so that will help by the oxytocin. So generally the uterine muscles are framed by the smooth muscles.